A court in Olongapo has dismissed the sedition charge against a teacher who offered a 50 million peso reward online for the life of President Duterte. Mike Navalio is on the line to tell us more. Mike, go ahead.
Hi, Rain. An Olongapo court has junked the inciting to sedition charge by the National Bureau of Investigation against a teacher who allegedly offered a 50 million reward on Twitter to anyone who could kill President Rodrigo Duterte. Olongapo City Regional Trial Court Branch 72 Judge Richard Paradeza, in an order Wednesday, quashed the information against Ronel Mas, saying that he was illegally arrested and his subsequent media confession did not cure the invalidity of the arrest. NBI operatives arrested Mas without a warrant on May 11 in Zambales after a co-teacher identified him as the owner of the Twitter account, which posted the now-deleted tweet. They brought him to the NBI headquarters in Manila, where he confessed to the media and apologized for his tweet. In indicting Mas, the Department of Justice said that while Mas's arrest was illegal, his subsequent admission to the media cured the illegal arrest. But while Judge Paradeza agreed with Dakpano that the arrest was unlawful, The NBI's own narration of facts showed that the arrest was made 6 days after the tweet was posted on May 5 and without the personal knowledge of whether Mas committed the crime, according to the judge. This is outside the scope of the rule on warrantless arrest under the rules of court because the arresting officer had no personal knowledge as to the crime committed by Mas. The court also said that the supposed confession to the media did not cure the invalidity of the arrest because evidence gathered as a consequence of unlawful arrest is inadmissible in evidence. An extrajudicial confession to be valid must not violate any of the rights of the accused under custodial investigation, which includes the right to have an independent and competent counsel. In this case, the court noted that during the supposed confession to the media, there was no lawyer present. This contradicts the DOJ prosecutor's inquest resolution, which ruled otherwise. Now, the court also took time to reiterate that while the posted tweet may have contained despicable and provocative language, the rights of the accused should still be respected. It noted that the supposed extrajudicial confession was not even presented by NBI to the inquest prosecutor and to the court. There was no affidavit of the person who interviewed Mas, nor the video clips of the supposed interview where he supposedly confessed to committing the crime. Rain?
Do we know where the teacher is now, and has there been any reaction on his side?
Well, we understand, Rain, that a few days after he was arrested, he actually posted bail. So he is out on bail. We haven't heard so far from, we're trying to reach out to the camp of Ronel Mas as to his reaction. But we are hearing from his counsel that they're actually relieved that this was the decision because several human rights groups and several human rights lawyers have actually questioned the ruling of the DOJ, saying that the supposed confession to the media will not have an effect of curing the illegal arrest, but will only have an effect on the admissibility of the evidence, the supposed confession or admission of Mas. So they're saying that Mas should have been released immediately because his arrest was illegal. Rain?
Well, it would be still interesting to follow this particular development. Thank you so much for that report, Mike Navalio.